It turns me on.
It's beautiful, it sounds like. Yeah.
Alright, that's not actually how it is in real life. Hang in there, sweetness. Said, hey, we've got a rain date open, and you know, there's no big advantage for us in doing this. But we would be happy to host you on that night. And we talked to Jen and Scott, and we said, you know, we love playing in Columbia, and we all decided that it was very important. You know, it's a free show for everybody, and it's a very rare opportunity for us to just kind of share and be merry. We decided that we better do this. And so we're out here, and then we looked at the forecast this morning, and it's exactly the same forecast from last time. And you brave, daring souls are out here, despite that forecast. And we done got lucky. So I'm very, very happy to be here. I'm very, very happy that you're here. We're called We're About Nine, and we're going to trust our short-term memories for the next 2 minutes.
To dream all night on my couch beside the window. I had to dream all night with my pillow and my throw. I had to dream all night to keep the dark away, to keep the dark away. Second closest star, more distant than Mars, at trillions of miles, it's farther than Mars. Flood my dissipate. Decays for years in space. The fragments are dreams, a light show display.
Holding our hopes
upright, when our own lights fade and flicker. Holding our hopes upright, when there's nothing we can say. I had to dream all night to keep the dark away, to keep the dark away.
Reasoning with greed and self.
that's all there is.
Could we get a little bit more Pat Clink guitar in the monitor and a little bit less Brian Gunderstorff guitar in the monitor?
And a little more clapping for Naked Blue, please. Dennis Gaskell. He'll be back after we do four songs. And then we all take a break. Most of what we're doing tonight is not stuff that you guys, those of you who only see us when we're in this part of the world, might have heard from us before. This is a lot of new stuff, and we haven't done a lot of new stuff anywhere in a long time.
True that, Pat Clink.
Ain't new stuff.
All right. Here's something new. That intro? Thank you. There it is again. Guitars, Daryl.
for a while there was some distant lightning. I don't know if any of you caught that. There was a cloud moving across that way to that way. In the middle. Boom, boom. It was lightning without thunder, but I wanted to give it that extra oomph. It needs some thunder, you know, when you think about it. Lightning and thunder, they go together. So it's pretty and you can admire it from a distance, but it's not here, right here. So that's a good thing.
So any of you that are familiar with the stretch between Massachusetts and here know that when we were making trips back and forth between the two places, it wasn't entirely simple. It was a short jaunt actually north on 95 to 90, to what, to 94, 80, 90, 84, 91, yeah, to 95, New Jersey Turnpike, back to 95, to
95.
New Jersey Turnpike. 95. 695.
There's a stretch of 95.
175.
That is not 95. It is oblivion.
True that.
It doesn't exist. Look it up on the map. It's there, I swear. It's not there. It's there. But it's not there. I'll tell you about it later if you really want to know.
Fabulous. Anyway, many of those roads are mentioned in this song. This is called The Hardest Thing to Prove.
Baltimore's plot out with its red polluted lights. I've eaten dried and packaged foods from the rest stops on the right. I watched Boston leave my sight. I've taken 95, 93, 90, 91, and 9. Why do I get so caught up in the search for something new? When something's never happened, it's the hardest thing to prove. And that same age-old conclusion is the only one I'm true. When I die, I hope there's something left to do. Some suburbia is the cradle of my life. My parents taught me right. Still, I picked up the guitar and rock and roll all night. But I've seen hillsides of people holding lights and signaling I'm right. And that everything I did, I had some reason why. But why do I get so caught up in the search for something new? When something's never happened, it's the hardest thing to prove. And that same age-old conclusion is the only one I drew. When I die, I hope there's something left to do. When I die, I hope there's a cello playing, kids obeying every saying. Jesus ever gave while he was young and misbehaved. If there's crying, if there's praying, well, I hope it's just that cello flute. Music shake their stomachs just by doing what she's practiced every day. Something's never happened. something new. When something's never happened, it's the hardest thing to prove. And that same age-old conclusion is the only one I drew. When I die, I hope there's something left to do. And when something's never happened, it's the hardest thing to prove.
A dozen years. We met at a coffee shop in Ellicott City, doing the open mic there. Never had any plans to make it rich and famous, and so far things are going pretty much according to our plan. But when I was a kid, famous was the thing. Famous was what everybody should be. If anybody asked me what they should be when they grew up, I told them they should be a star. I since regret that advice a little bit, and this is my homage. One more song, and then Jen and Scott Smith, Naked Blue, are back up here.
Break for a second, actually.
Exactly. Then we take a break. We meet each other. Everybody's got CDs. They've got awesome CDs. We've got awesome CDs.
One, two, three.
Bracing yourself for the media. is like quitting cold turkey, and that's what you did in a cell in the suburbs, reading your letters. They love you, they hate you, they hope you get better. I shrugged when I told you to go be a star. Now I blame myself, and that's what you are. And that's what you are.
Thank you.
Thanks so much. Naked Blue will be up in a few minutes. Have a little break. Meet your neighbors.
Dig again. Still damp, not so hot. Feels better to me now.
Sleepless. It's a longer day. It's a longer day. love to hear you guys sing, so if you recognize this next one, I think you will. We would like you to sing along. The crickets are singing along. Scott and I have a bet every April of when one will hear the first cricket outside. And they were early this year. Sometimes it's not till August, and this year it was July, right? Some of my family showed up, which I love that you're here. But sometimes family makes you nervous. Does anybody have a big family out there? Nobody? Big family? Anybody? There's a few. There you go. That little bit of baggage from things that people have said to you in the past, like my sister who, right before a really big show a couple years ago, said, Remember when you were to, it was Constitution Hall or something where you really want to have your game on? She said, remember when you were two and I walked in and you were in your playpen and you had taken all the poop out of your diaper and spread it all over yourself? She said, you had a smile on your face. It's just like the smile I see sometimes when you're singing. Julie, thanks for that. So this next song is brand new. It's the closest thing we've ever done to social commentary. Don't be scared. It's about oil and money and fast food. Huh? You are. And it's on our website. We just put it up. But one thing we're doing tonight, if anybody wants to find us again, if you want to sign up on our mailing list tonight, we will send you a free download of this song or another song of your choice. Have a round of applause for them. Can you sing with me, please, William? So I know everybody here probably has a thing. Most people have a thing they work hard on, like fly fishing or yoga or writing a song or jiu-jitsu. And you spend hours and hours and hours. Macrame.
Perhaps.
Grilling. But you spend hours and hours honing your skill, and then all of a sudden, one day, there's this moment where it just, you're not even thinking about it, and everything just falls into place. Kind of how communities work that way sometimes, too. Like tonight, out here on this beautiful night. But then, you know, it all comes crashing down a second later. And that's what this song's about. Thank you very much. Come and find us at nakedblue.com. It's family friendly, and have a great night.
Naked Blue, ladies and gentlemen, Naked Blue.
We're at 9, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, this is wicked fun. Thanks for sticking around, everybody. We're off to round 4.
I'm gonna plug in, Daryl.
Hold me.
That's a good start.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a big Columbia Lakefront round of applause for Daryl Beard on the sound? Thank you.
No, I'm just, that's fine.
Let's do it.
For coming out. I know they just said that, but I thought that if you heard something 2 or 3 times, you might remember it. So thank you.
You guys know how to play?
Yeah.
I can maybe come down a pinch in the wedge, do so. Since you went and made me all big and pretty.
Naked Blue has all kinds of CDs that you should own. I love their CDs, and I want to promote them to you, and I have done as such. We Were About Nine also has some CDs, and this is a tune off of, 3 releases ago now, a CD called Engine. We stopped playing this song from Engine almost immediately as soon as we recorded it because we liked the recording so much we didn't think that we held up to it live, but we fixed it at long last, and this is it for you. This is called Yeehaw. I am a book from the 20th century on the top of your bureau drawer. And my chapters are a bit out of order now, but if you're patient, you can find what you are looking for. I am a rough draft and I am an edit. I am the third time around and I still don't get it.
The hard way, the only way I know.
Well, this is a song for the ladies in the house.
It's a song from our blue disc. The blue disc is called Paper Dust Stardust. We changed things up on that record a little bit. Let me tell you more about that later. But Brian likes to imagine himself in other people's shoes. Try them on, size 6, size 7, size 12. And then go from there, see where it takes them. I'm like, can I walk around in these shoes? They're not too small.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Katie Grabiel moment. Miss Jen, get up here. Yeah, not just a fabulous singer, songwriter, guitar player, but also the owner of that beautiful cello that you see there, and she knows how to play it, ladies and gentlemen. Jen and I coordinated this morning. I said I'm bringing the bluish teal glockenspiel, and she said, well, I'll wear my bluish teal dress. You hear that, right?
More glockenspiel.
More glockenspiel. This is the only instrument I ever bought at a clothing store. The thing that was going on in Boston, so we would go out to the venues. There's a lot of places where you can see a series of performers all in one night up there, and we would go out, and there was this trend going on where all the cool performers had these glockenspiels that they were playing the shows with, and I looked at all of them doing it, and I thought it sounded really great, and I thought it was like a relatively simple thing for me to pick up, having a little keyboard experience, and I thought I could do that, and it's really cool, but everybody else is already cool doing it, and I don't need to step on those grounds. I do not need to go out to the music store and buy a glockenspiel. And then I went out clothing shopping one day, and right in the middle of the clothing store was a glockenspiel. And I thought, okay, well, this is somebody trying to tell me something, so.
Hey, Scott, do you want to play guitar on this song? He says, don't have to talk about it. I mean, you know what, just jump up if you want, because I think that's really cool if you just jump up in the middle of the song.
It's in the people's key.
Smith on the CELLO.
Right.
two favorite things together.
So this is it. This is our last little, like, 4 or 5 minute adventure together.
Until next year's 89 degree, 30 degree chance of rain day. We've been doing this show on 89 degree, 30% chance of rain days since about 1999.
I think that's right.
Right on this year's stage.
You guys are brave. You guys are really brave. I love it.
They're not that brave. They don't have instruments out here, sound gear, microphones.
I'm sure they have, like, cell phones. We love you, too.
I don't know what you said, but it was really nice. Had a good tone to it.
Come and see us again. We have a mailing list, and Naked Blue has a mailing list, and we have CDs, and that means you can take us home with you, and it doesn't cost that much, really, for a night home. You know, you can take us around in your car every single day. It's a pretty cheap date. So consider that while you're listening to this one.
Shine. It's you and the mountain.
Sweep and We're About Nine. David Naked Blue. Scott, get back up here real quick for a big bow. Let's do a big dramatic bow. Ready, run. Run fast.
Ladies and gentlemen, We're About Nine and Naked Blue. Woo!